Max, as we all know, CRO industry has been changing rapidly. So we decided to ask you a couple of questions about the current situation and the current trends in the industry, if that's okay with you.
Absolutely.
So my first question is, what do you think is the most important driver for a client to choose a CRO for a cooperation? And could you please maybe rank them from the most to least important?
Sure. Again, it depends on the sponsor, it depends on the CRO. But 9 times out of 10, what I'm hearing is it's about the relationship. It's about the correct culture fit. And it's about knowing that the team you take on is the team that you keep. Secondly, timelines. We're spending $20 billion on clinical trials. Time is absolute essence. And with that, of course, comes cost. Unfortunately, and it still happens, especially with phase one and two, cost is everything. So sometimes it can compromise, sometimes it doesn't. So the other element that comes into that, of course, is quality. And how do you balance quality and cost?
What do you think are the main threats in the industry and why?
I think the main threat we have today is cybersecurity. For the first time in 5,000 years, we are producing more data this year than ever before. It's absolutely imperative that both the sponsor and the CRO can protect their data and know that it's safe. So most certainly cybersecurity. The other thing actually is patients, and I'm very glad to be able to say that, because now patients have an opinion, they have a voice. But at the same time, it can be a concern because they can Google, they have as much information very often as we do. So we have to be able to respect our patients, to be able to recruit them, and also more importantly, to be able to retain them and listen to their voice and their opinion.
And do you think regulatory aspects can be an issue as well?
Absolutely. To try and keep up with the changes with the FDA, with the EMA, it's an ongoing process. And again, a lot of it there links back into data. So yes, regulatory is a significant issue. It's also becoming more difficult and more of a challenge to have studies approved. So yes, it is a big concern.
So my last question for today will be, do you think there are any new technologies that are likely to disrupt the industry in the next 10 years?
I think the biggest disruption, which will be a positive disruption, is digitalization. We cannot continue with our data management and our control of data as it is. Companies are building platforms upon platforms, but we can't keep up. And I can see in the next few years that we will go digital, where our patients can actually stay at home without going into clinical trial centres, where they can wear a watch, or they can have a phone, or they can have a pack on their body that measures their temperature and their blood pressure and everything else. So yes, disruption, but in a very, very positive way.
Thank you very much for your time.
My pleasure.
Appreciate it.